Hi guys, our first week of the new season is now done, and we're on to episode 2. Last week's game was the classic shmup R-Type, released in 1987 by Irem. Over on the Discord, there's been some discussion about whether Gradius or R-Type is the better game. I've only played Gradius 3 and Gradius 5, so I'm not best placed to compare, but I quite enjoyed playing R-Type, and it definitely grew on me over the course of the week. The unique feature of R-Type at the time was the auxiliary weapon called the Force, that can be used at different points as both a shield, but also a detachable weapon, to deliver damage while you hide elsewhere. There is much to like about R-Type. The presentation is great, with excellent sprite work, lovely colours, and superb music. The game mechanic and weapons are good, and the bosses are pretty epic. The downside is the fact that it's totally a memory and set-piece game, but that's true of a lot of shmups. The first three levels I initially found a little challenging, but once I worked out what I needed to do, they're actually pretty straightforward, and I can clear them most times at a first attempt, which I did when recording the footage here. Level 4 is still a memory game, but the difficulty ramps up significantly, and I wasn't able to clear the boss on that stage. Not being able to clear level 4 left me with the strategy of milking points on level 3. Given the whole level is one big boss, dying puts you back to the beginning, so once you're confident in beating it, you can complete all but the final shot of the boss for about 35,000 points each go, and then sacrifice your life. Do this for each of the lives you have, and you can get over 250,000 points. This does point to a slightly broken scoring mechanic, where you can get further in the game, but achieve a lower score, which is always a little frustrating, especially given the dramatic increase in difficulty after level 3. All of our top 3 were able to get past level 4 though, so let's see how everyone did. We had 18 submissions last week, which was great, including 2 new submitters, Steve's Retro and Shmuppin' Lovin'. Competition to get into the top 10 was pretty fierce, with 190,000 points required just to get into the points. That spot was taken by our Season 3 third place finisher, Bob. Ian put in an early 200,000, but has been pushed down the list and has ended up in 9th. The first of our new entrants is Steve's Retro, who's finished in 8th. We've got regulars Paul and Mark in 6th and 7th. I'm pretty pleased with my 5th place finish, and we've got the second of our new entrants, Shmuppin' Lovin', in 4th with 270,000, just sneaking ahead of me this morning. Our top 3 though, all separated themselves from the pack. All got beyond the challenging level 4, and were each leading at different stages. Finishing 3rd is our Season 3 winner, Andrew, who was the most vocal about preferring Gradius to R-Type. I'm sure he'll be back with some table-topping performances soon. In 2nd place is our Shmup Specialist, matching his best performance in the competition, and just 10,000 points off the top spot, is Big Jaffa. But starting Season 4 off with a win, after taking 2 wins last season, with a table-topping score of 370,000 points, is Ten Shearers. A very well done to him, and I'm hoping for a close battle for the top spot this season. Here is the first appearance of the score distribution histogram this season. As a reminder, the scores are converted to the log scale, binned, and then are increasing left to right. This week, you can see that everyone is pretty close. There are no gaps between the bins, and every bin has at least 2 members. The top 10 fill just 3 bins, with 8th to 10th in one bin, 7th to 4th in the next, and the top 3 all in the same bin. Those that finished at the bottom of each bin can probably consider themselves a little unlucky. Unlike at times last season, when we had a runaway winner, all of the top 3 are very close, and only a little ahead of everyone else. I think this reflects the sharp increase in difficulty of level 4 onwards, that most were able to get to level 3 or 4, but even our best this week didn't get that much further. With our first game done, on to this week's choice. The game this week is another of Alan's favourites, but it was also our most selected game from last season, having been selected 5 times, and that was Rolling Thunder, released by Namco in 1986. You play as a secret agent who's trying to save his female partner from a terrorist organisation. So pretty generic story here, but arcade games are rarely about the story. This game really moved the side-scrolling action game on, with one of the main innovations being the ability to jump between upper and lower levels, the other being the duck and cover mechanic, along with the overall execution, as you'd expect from Namco. Shinobi from Sega that we had last season appeared the following year, and is clearly heavily inspired by Rolling Thunder. Let's see how it compares, as I've not played much Rolling Thunder before, but my gut feeling is that it's probably the better game. But we'll see. Once again, I'm expecting this to be a pretty popular choice. we'll be playing the Rev 3 ROM with default settings. So let's see how you all do at Rolling Thunder this week, and I'll be back with the scores next week. See you then.